Happy Monday, everyone. It is currently past 5 in the afternoon. I just got home from work, so I'm starting this vlog today, and I will probably vlog up until Friday. It is the 26th today? 26th? Yeah, April 26th. And I have barely read a book this month, so I am starting this vlog to keep myself accountable and to force myself to read more. I have been in a slump, a little bit of a slump this month, and I did buy a lot of books, and I kind of made a silent deal with myself that I will not be buying more books than I will be reading off of my TBR or be taking off of my TBR. I have not managed that this month just yet, and I only have 4 days left, so I need to work a little bit harder on that. Let me update you on what I am currently reading. I hope this is in focus, but I'm currently reading The Outsiders by S.E. Hinton. I am on page 95. I started at page 70, but I read 25 pages today at work, so not too bad, especially since I should be working. I am also listening to Harry Potter and the Order of the Phoenix. I have a newly tradition that I start each year off by rereading the entire Harry Potter series, or in this case I'm listening to all of the audiobooks because I absolutely love Stephen Fry's reading of the Harry Potter books. So far I have finished the first 4 books and I'm now on the 5th book. And yeah, I'm really enjoying it, but it doesn't help with lowering my TBR since it is a reread. So it's kind of a priority for me to finish this as quickly as possible so I can start a new audiobook that is actually on my TBR. I also received a book from netgalley called Midnight Hour. I will show you the cover here. It is an anthology of, I believe, 19 or 20 black authors. So far, I am around 70% in, and I really want to finish that as well because I acquired it this month, so it would be great if I could take it off my TBR this month as well. My plans are to read as many small books as possible, so I also have We Were Liars by E. Lockhart ready to go, and The Great Gatsby by F. Scott Fitzgerald. Those are both relatively small, I believe. We Were Liars is around 220 to 30. Yeah, 225. And The Great Gatsby is 151. So, should be quite easy, but you never know. Especially since I only have 4 days left and I'm not the fastest reader. So far today I have read 25 pages of The Outsiders at work. And I have started listening to Harry Potter and the Order of the Phoenix while driving home. I started at page 483. I don't know where I'm up to now, not much further, because I like to listen to it on regular speed because I love the way Stephen Fry reads this. My goal for today before I go to bed is to have finished The Outsiders, which I only have 50 pages left, something like that, so that should be doable. And I would also like to get up to the point where I only have 9.5 hours left in the audiobook for Order of the Phoenix. If I manage that, I will be able to finish the audiobook before Friday, and hopefully I can listen to another audiobook the entirety of Friday. Today is Tuesday, it is King's Day. For those of you who don't know, here in the Netherlands, we celebrate our King's birthday by King's Day. And it's a national holiday, so most of us don't have to work today, like me. My boyfriend does have to work for about half a day, so he'll be joining me later and we'll take a walk. But until then, I have plenty of time to get a lot of reading done. Last night I finished The Outsiders. It was a really good story. I forgot to tell you what it is about. It's kind of like a coming of age story about a 14-year-old boy called Pony Boy, which is an unusual name. And he's kind of born on the wrong side of the tracks kind of story. I gave it 4 stars. The beginning, I didn't care for the beginning very much, but the ending really had me gripped and I read that so quickly. Today I started in We Were Liars. I am on page 34, so not that very far in, but I only read in that book this morning. Then I went for a walk, listened to the audiobook of Harry Potter and the Order of the Phoenix. I managed to get up to the point where I only had 8 hours and 50 minutes left yesterday. And today I've been listening to it for quite a long time. Let's see. I have 6.5 hours left. And it's now midday. So I will get myself a cup of tea and continue reading in. I will start in We Were Liars. I want to get up to the halfway point before my boyfriend gets home. And I would also love to get... I would also love to get to around page 650 in this. I'm currently about there. That should be doable for today. But every minute I listen to it more than I'm supposed to is always better, because I want to finish it before Friday, because on Friday I want to start a new one. I would love to tell you about We Were Liars and what it's about, but I'm only 34 pages in and I'm very confused. It says on the back, "We are liars, we are beautiful and privileged, we are cracked and broken, a tale of love and romance, a tale of tragedy, which are lies, which is truth. You decide." There have been a couple of instances where I was like, yeah, this is a lie. Like getting shot multiple times and bleeding to death a couple of times and then, you know, reviving again. I suppose they're all lies and kind of like metaphors. But I wonder if there's anything else that I didn't notice that was a lie. But then again, I'm only on page 34, so without giving you spoilers, I will update you later if I understand which are lies and which aren't. Good morning, it is Wednesday. I thought I'd update you real quick before I have to leave the house. So I managed to get to page 75 of We Were Liars. And I managed to listen to 60 pages of the Harry Potter book, but I only read like up until 1 o'clock, because when my boyfriend came home at around 1, we got invited by our neighbor to have some drinks. She had a whole setup outside with benches and stuff, and it was lovely, but we stayed there up until 8 o'clock. And when I came home, I had way too much wine to even read a letter. So I started reading this morning again, listened to the audiobook for 20 more pages. Now I'm gonna get ready, because today I am going to my parents' house. Then we're all going to a place called Giethoorn, and we're renting a boat and staying on the boat almost all day, so hopefully the weather is nice. I am bringing my book, I am bringing my camera, so hopefully I can read and vlog a little bit. otherwise this will be a very boring vlog so far. I'm gonna try to finish We Were Liars today because it is Wednesday. Tomorrow I have to work and I also have to finish Midnight Hour. I keep forgetting about Midnight Hour because I have a digital copy. I hope when I talk to you next time it will be on the boat. So this is the moment where I find out how good my microphone is, because I have to talk real soft. My boyfriend is sleeping upstairs and we have like an open floor plan all the way up to upstairs. There's no walls or anything, so he can probably hear me, and he's a very light sleeper, so I'm trying to talk as quietly as possible. I was on the boat nearly all day. I finished my audiobook for Harry Potter, so tomorrow I will be starting a new audiobook. And I've nearly finished We Were Liars. I'm on page 180 and it goes to 236, I believe. So I will finish that tonight before bed, and then tomorrow while I'm at work, I will try to finish Midnight Hour. I'm 71% in because it is a book from netgalley. I don't know at what page I am at, but I'm 71% in, so I'm hoping to finish that tomorrow. And then I will start my new audiobook tomorrow as well. And then Friday, I want to finish my audiobook. And yeah, I was thinking of reading The Great Gatsby as well, but I don't think that's necessary anymore because I've read a sufficient amount, I think. I will be updating my bullet journal on Friday, so on Friday I will know how many books I've actually taken off my DVR and how many books I've acquired. I also unhauled quite a lot of books, so I will check if that balances. Okay, for now I am going to finish We Were Liars, and then I will update you later on my thoughts on the books, what the book is about a little bit without spoiling it. See you in the next clip, which will probably be tomorrow. Okay, I hope it's focused and I hope it doesn't stop recording. Yesterday when I came home from work, I filmed a little bit to update you on where I'm at with my reading and talk to you about what the books I read were about. And then my camera decided to stop recording and I didn't notice until I was done. So after that I didn't feel like re-recording it. So I'm explaining it to you now. I'm gonna put in a hair mask before I go in the shower, so I've got some time on my hands anyway. Yesterday at work I finished reading Midnight Hour, the anthology by 20 authors of color. I rated it 3 stars. Because that was the average of all of the 20 stories that I read. Like some of them I gave 5 stars, some of them I gave 4, 3, 2. But then the average of them all was a 3-star. If you want a detailed review, I suggest you check out my Goodreads. So far the book only got 1 other review. Which was a 5-star review. So even if you won't be able to find my Goodreads, if you just find the book, I will be the other review. Also, I gave We Were Liars, which I finished reading on Wednesday, 5 stars.
I was invested all the way through, but it was a 4-star read up until the ending. The ending fucked me. Oh my god. I was in all kinds of states after that. I don't think I've told you much about We Were Liars, but it's very difficult to explain. We follow a 14-year-old girl, and you kind of get to hear several different timelines. So first the summer of 2008, then the summer of 2015, and then the summer of 2017. And the summer of 2017 is the present. And then while the summer of 2017 is going on, you get several flashbacks to the summer of 2015, because something happened in the summer of 2015, but our main character doesn't know what. I believe she's 17. I think I said 14. I mean 17. So yesterday I started the audiobook for The Owl Always Hunts at Night by Samuel Bjørk. It is a book that I had on my TBR, and I reckon I can listen to this audiobook on 2x speed, so finish it real quick today. I've only listened to about an hour yesterday, so that is my plan for today. While also cleaning and getting my bullet journal in order, and I wanted to go for a walk, but she might be able to hear. I'm not sure if you'll be able to hear because I'm in the bathroom, but it's raining. I'm gonna leave this in for now, get some cleaning done, and then I'm gonna take a shower. So while I'm cleaning, I'm gonna listen to the audiobook and I will update you frequently. I have not yet finished my audiobook for The Owl Always Hunts at Night, but I only have less than an hour left, so I thought I'd finish my vlog here. I thought I'd round up the vlog here now that I still have some daylight left. Let me update you on everything I've read. So these are all of the books that I read in this vlog. I of course still have to finish this one. I have the Dutch version, but this is The Owl Always Hunts at Night, Order of the Phoenix, We Were Liars, and The Outsiders. And then also you need to pretend that in here is midnight hour. I will leave that up there. I have updated my bullet journal up to the point where I now know if I managed to get my goal of bringing my TBR down. So here we go. I acquired this month Black Leopard, Red Wolf. I will show you all of the covers here. Library of Souls, Phoenician Betrayal, Women Don't Owe You Pretty, The Color Purple, We Were Liars, The Epic of Gilgamesh, The Outsiders, Don Quixote, Pieces of Her, which I borrowed, and Midnight Hour, which I got from netgalley. That's 11 books. Oops. I read 7 books, but one was a reread. So I read Pieces of Her, The Templar Legacy, The Outsiders, We Were Liars, Harry Potter and the Order of the Phoenix, which was my reread, Midnight Hour, and The Owl Always Hunts at Night. That's 7 books read, but one was a reread, so I added 11 and took off 6, which is nowhere near enough. But the books that I unhauled, The Obsidian Throne, which was a DNF for me, Catch Me When I Fall, this one is called Zonder Gezicht, but I will leave the English titles down below here, Winter in Madrid, also Dutch, but I will leave the English translation right there, Secret Smile, and Libri di Luca. So I unhauled 6 books, which brings me 12 down And therefore, my TBR is down to 113 books instead of 114. Which isn't exactly the goal I'm going for. Well, it is. I mean, I have less books on my TBR, but it's just one less. And I've had that for a couple of months now. I mean, I started in January with counting my TBR, and I had 120 books on my TBR. So in 4 months, I only took off 5 books. Which could be better. I'm sorry if you can hear the church bells, it does that every 15 minutes. Anyway, I still have to finish my last book, but I think it's gonna be a 4-star read for me. It wasn't like overwhelmingly special, but I do love Samuel Bjørk's writing style. And I love following the characters of Mia Krueger and Munch. I think that's how you pronounce it. I don't believe I have told you the premise of the story. So we follow Mia Krueger and Munch, which are the two characters in all of the books. In this story, it starts with a couple of different narratives, and you follow a different set of people. I only have 1 hour left to go, and I still don't know what the beginning was about, so I hope I find out soon. But yeah, it actually really starts when they find a 22-year-old girl in a lake, dead, and she is wearing like her full-on ballet clothes. She has like a tutu and her whatever those shoes are called. But it's high up in the mountains and it's hella cold there. So what happened there? And it almost seems like she willingly walked there. So it was murder, but why did she walk all the way up there when she was not dressed for the weather? And I think I'm gonna just leave it at that because I don't like to spoil thrillers too much. I always feel like if you read the back of thrillers, you're like spoiled for half the story. It's better if you know almost nothing, so plot twists are still plot twists. And you're not like, well, saw that coming from a mile away because of the back. I reckon this was kind of a short vlog, but I hope this is my way back to BookTube. I've filmed several videos in the last couple of months, but none of them actually made it online. Of course, the pandemic hit, and I still have quite a lot of things going on in my life with studying and internship and working. So that's why I took a little bit of a break off of BookTube. Hopefully this is kind of my way back in. I will try to film a video each month and upload one video each month. And then slowly up that to maybe 2 a month, and then we'll see from there. I am still kind of active on my Instagram, so if you want to follow me on there, I will leave the link down below. I stopped using my Twitter because I found out Twitter, especially book Twitter, is a very toxic place, and I do not want to be on there anymore. So you can follow me on Instagram, you can follow me on Goodreads, and of course you can subscribe to my channel. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up, and I will see you in my next video. Bye!